Hello everybody and welcome back to the Ultimate RTG. We've got another icon. Who is it? Well, we sold Boateng, who we've been using for over 450 games. I got him when he was about 110,000 coins, sold him on for 165. So the only real upgrade and replacement was one man, Rio Ferdinand. I used him in the last episode and he was a brick wall. On a smooth connection, I felt exactly what he was about. His tackling, the interceptions, everything. That is the centre back that you need in your side. And alongside Rijkaard, this is the partnership of dreams. So he cost me, altogether, if you're including the icon, it was 843,000. I will break down the price of exactly what I've been doing. So at the time, I was about 70,000 coins short. So I had to go through all of the low rated rare cards. So the 75 overalls, I had a ton. I was either selling them if they were worth anything on the market or just discarding them. And eventually I got enough coins to afford it. And one thing that we had in our favor, remember when we did those two player packs, we had a couple of untradeables, Ericsson 87 rated. And then not to mention the monthly reward cards that are useless to us, I just dropped into the SBC. So the first one, you were needing an icon, which cost 300,000 coins. That was Schmeichel. Thank God he's gone. The next team was West Ham, that we packed Fabregas yesterday in the weekly reward. So that was awesome. He didn't even walk out. Don't know what that was about. 25,000 coins altogether there. The Leeds United team was 13,000. Most expensive player, Gary Cahill. The Man United team, it caught me out off guard with this one. 105,000. The reason for that, I believe you were needing so many Premier League players, and then you had to like bring up the rating as well. So Mkhitaryan, Coutinho, they all had to be purchased with a 95 chemistry rating. That was a little bit serious. Then we go to the 84 rated side, 55k, which was good. 85, 95. 86 was the most expensive one because I didn't really use that many monthly reward cards, which was 160. And the 87 only cost us 90k because, like I said, we had Ericsson and a couple of informs that you would have seen. I think it was Hilton, Adante or Hilton that we used, the Brazilian centre back. He was untradeable from those two player packs. So that was pretty damn sweet. So altogether, it costs 843,000. Ignore the icon, that is 543k. So we just about had enough. We've got the packs to open today. And I do want to speak about my actual player of the month, Salah Investments. You know that he's going to win. And the reason why I haven't been doing investments as much, because a lot of you, well, not a lot, but a portion of you think that I do it to like price fix the players. But it has nothing to do with that. Like, I don't even make coins off of investments anymore because I just decided not to do it. But if you want to see that, and I'll let you know exactly who to go for, then please drop it in the comment section. And I'm going to be doing it today, so I'm not telling you to buy my actual players, but I've got a really good investment that probably will make you like a few coins, and it's very low risk as well. You're not going to lose anything. You're going to make coins. That's what I'm telling you to do it. But don't copy me exactly. Just take that advice and do it with another player. So are you guys ready? Let's go and I guess open the packs first. Let's go and open these packs. We've got Rio Ferdinand, and then we'll speak about Salah. Hold up, before we go and open these packs, I seriously need to give you a transfer update. A ton of players were sold to afford Rio Ferdinand, and although we had a mini club clear out, we've still got a load of other cards. So if we, well, decided, I don't really like to do club clear outs on RTGs, because then if marquee matchups are released, then we won't have those cards because we've got rid of them. And I feel that it's a little bit pointless. But if we did get rid of everything, probably another like 200,000-300,000 coins sitting in this club. It's amazing. So Lozano we sold for 27,750 as we packed the monthly reward card, so we made profit there. The left wing back, 42,000. I sold both of them. 42k. He is the best option though to go for, and I will try him when his price drops. Boateng that we played over 450 games and we bought him for about 110,000. So 169, and that was a large like percentage of how we were able to afford Rio Ferdinand. And those were just like random informs that we got from the rewards. And these were the kind of players I started to sell. And I thought, I don't really want to get rid of them just in case they are going to release like team of the group stage SBCs or something like that. So I decided to hold off from those and just get rid of the 75 golds. So I checked the market if they sold. Well, most of them didn't. They were like 600 coins. So I just discarded a ton, which really brought up the overall coins. And then I think it was Iniesta, yeah. So Iniesta I was going to use in the last SBC, the 87 rated side, and I found out that I could get away with using Immobile, and I got this guy for, it was 26,500. I sniped him for 26,500, and then I realized, hold on a minute, I don't need him. So I sold him for 30k. Koulibaly we had already at the club, and then a couple of other players that I want to speak about in a minute. Wow, we scraped some coins together. We were just able to afford, what is his name? Rio Ferdinand, that's the one. So I'm really happy with that. Great purchase, or great unlock. And now we're going to go and see how many coins we can make back from these packs. So it should be good. Drop a like on the video if you enjoy the series, and let's do it. So our weekly and monthly packs weren't too kind to us. We got Fabregas, and he didn't even walk out. So that basically sums up that pack opening. What I really wanted to do, though, is, at the time, we didn't have enough coins to go out and purchase Mertens, and I didn't really feel like going through my whole club to just bring in an informer card. But then I was interested in unlocking Rio Ferdinand, and it's basically re-rolling our luck. So we're going to open all of these packs. We've unlocked Rio, which is a great addition to the side. Now we need to make like 600,000 coins. We've got 100k pack, we've got like mega pack as well. I'm feeling pretty good today. If we can make back like 200,000-300,000 coins, that'd be absolutely insane. So let's start off with the Jumbo Premium Gold Pack. An inform Griezmann or anyone like that. Surely not too many people are opening up packs. So maybe it'd bring us better pack luck. I was really happy though, packing that left wing back twice. That's 42,000 coins. Joe Hart, there we go. You were needing Joe Hart in the SBC, but he's not too expensive at all for the West Ham one. So I will most likely just keep hold of him. John Terry, not a draft token. What? 15,000 coins. Hey, should we play the draft in the next episode? And yeah, by the way, the draft series I've put on hold for now. I just haven't really been enjoying it that much. And a lot of you guys that don't watch it, it's not really worth my time spending hours upon hours editing something like that where I'm not really enjoying it as much. I feel like I just get the same players just over and over again. So until they bring out like special promos with Team of the Year, then I'll start it back up. But yeah, draft token, that is pretty mad. Right, let's redeem it. Ever since I changed my controller, I've had some really bad pack luck, I'm not gonna lie. And I ran out of the grip, the Xbox grip, so I just got the PlayStation one and cut it. It actually looks pretty good. It's not even like a special Xbox controller, it's just one of those standard ones. I don't really feel the need to go and purchase like scuff controllers or anything like that for FIFA. Like, there's no real use. Like, you can't get any use out of the flappy paddles or whatever they've put on the back. That's only for COD and stuff. This stuff, yeah. Okay, we're gonna store all that in. Two jumbos, nothing. Third one, a glow at least. 3-0 glow. Or lights. What do you even call it? Ericsson? No, it's not gonna be Ericsson, for God's sake. It's Vass. Yeah, I've got his monthly reward card, and he's solid, you know. Medium work rates, just holds it down. He's a good card. I'd like to, for him to get another inform. Then you've got a serious contender to be bringing into your, like, weekly sides. Oh, 1,000 coins, thank you. So now we're starting to get rid of those poopy packs. Bring on the real quality. There we go. Glow, at least. Come on. Huge. Don't give me Spanish. Center back. Ooh. Oh, very nice. 85 rated, Rafael Varane. Is he still 50,000 coins? I remember he was like 55k not so long ago. That is a huge pull to start things off. I like that. 85 and Mascherano, who's in at 83. That is sick, right? If he's like 30, 40. Oh, it got me all excited. 30,000 coins. That's still good, though. That's actually really good. Right, I'm listening him up. I have no use for Rafael Varane, and you wouldn't really use someone like him in an SBC because he's like, he's good. Like, you want to use him. So 30k, and that stuff I'm going to store in. Good, thank you. So that was the appetizer right there, getting those taste buds going. Big things to come right now. So mega pack time. Here we go. 18 rares. What are the chances that this isn't going to glow? Don't do it. It's done it to me. How? Why are you doing this, EA? So rude. Carlos Vela, so rude. I mean, how many rares are in this pack? And not to get an 83. Not even just an 83. Wow. I mean, that is shocking. That really is so bad. With the amount of consumables in that last pack, we can let them off. This one, though, all players, all rare. And how many are we getting? 12. 12 items. All players. it's this new controller. I swear to God, ever since I got this controller, I've had zero pack luck. 80 lens. I mean, it's unbelievable, really. 12 players this time, and I haven't even gotten 81. I'm telling you right now, this has to be a big walkout. Someone who's valued at 100,000 coins, because then added to Rafael Varane and all of the other players, that's good. Like, that's like 150,000. If we can make that back, I would be satisfied. So let's get the 100,000 coin pack out of the way. I'm pretty sure it is. Oh, thank you very much. We still haven't packed an icon, though. No. How much is he? I remember he was about 200,000 coins, right? But that was when he was needed for the player of the month, Mane. Maybe we keep him for player of the month, Salah. I don't think you would need him. No, all right, ignore that. Mane, though, 84. That's a good pull. And I don't think we've packed him on this account. So that is pretty sweet. I don't use him that much. Tolisso, I like that. Oh, yes, please. Jesus. This is a good pack. Very, very nice. So now we've made 30,000 coins from Rafael Varane, 30k from Jesus, and then how much is Mane? Please say he's about like 60. Please. 40. Oh, no. He used to be like 200,000 or 70k. I can't remember. He's about 30,000 coins. So yeah, we're pushing 100,000 coins just to offer three players. So that is pretty good. I like that. I'm actually going to sell Mane. I'm going to sell Jesus because they are pretty expensive. And the rest of them, I'm going to keep at the club. I'm not really sure why this pack was at the end. Three rares, 12 players. What are the chances that we get a better player out of this one? No, I don't think so. And it's not glowing brilliant. I'm skipping it. But Mane, I wouldn't say I'm very happy, but I'm satisfied with what we've got there. Three players, about 100,000 coins, added to all of the other stuff that we've got in the packs. Definitely pushing like 150,000, 160,000. That's not bad. I like that. That's really helped us out a little bit. And then I can use those coins to make even more investments. So let's go and speak about that. I'll give you some advice and let you know what I'm gonna be doing. So we have sold Gabriel Jesus for 29,750, and I'm waiting for these two guys to sell so I can free up some coins and purchase a few more Daniele De Rossis. Now, why am I gonna be investing in Daniele De Rossi? So this Friday, we have a guaranteed player of the month. It's Salah, no question. His month, unbelievable, right? He's doing amazing things for Liverpool right now. So I'm thinking if they ask for maybe a previous club for one of the requirements, or they even ask you to build a Roma team, if you're needing a decent rating, which I believe it's going to be because of how many special cards he's already had. So Daniele De Rossi ticks the rating. He's, well, from Roma, that's a plus. So you've got two requirements there. And then if we think about what is going to happen in the future, we future-proof ourselves. You know, they release those in-form SBCs where you get a guaranteed SBC put in an 83-rated side. Well, Team of the Group stage is going to be released sometime, well, maybe even this Friday. I think it's next Friday. I believe there's one more game to be played. So if that is the case, on the Saturday, they could well drop a guaranteed Team of the Group stage SBC where you're needing an 83-rated side again. So with everyone dumping the 83s back on the market for, well, 1,800 coins. You've got this one for 2,005 that I started to snipe. And I realized, hang on a minute, I can get him for a little bit cheaper. So all of these De Rossis that I've got here, even if it doesn't come through the first investment for Player of the Month Salah, next week, we could see him go up to 3,005, 4,000 coins for the Team of the Group stage one. So I think that is a safe investment. I'm not telling you guys, trust me, I'm not telling you guys, go out and purchase De Rossi's because I've got him. I'm not saying that. Just think about it like this. 83 rated cards, any 83s could be a good investment. Not for the player of the month. I'm talking the Team of the Group stage SBC. But if you're wanting to focus on Salah, you've got gold Egyptian players. Any high rated cards from Liverpool, great investment. And just in general, like high rated cards from the Premier League. And maybe even Salah, like a Salah card himself could be asked for. So I think that is some nice tips for you. And for me, I think De Rossi is a very safe investment. He gets both of the requirements, one for the player of the month and one for the team in the group stage. So hopefully that has helped you out. I think we're going to go and jump in and play some games in Division 1 today, warm up with the side. It is so nice. I played a couple of games and it's just insane. Let's go and take a look. So I do want to quickly shout out the person that tweeted me to tell me, what are you doing? Don't sub out Lozano, or sub in Lozano, I should say. Just take out Jaccarini, change up your formation, and this is how to get it on full chemistry. So you know who you are. I appreciate you. And it's just amazing that you cared enough to actually tweet me. So it's fantastic. I'm loving the RTG right now. So with Rio Ferdinand, that is a brilliant upgrade. Now, Boateng, I haven't really got anything bad to say about him. Maybe in some situations it would be nice for him to have a little bit more pace, but even then it didn't really affect him that much. So Boateng is a fantastic purchase for you guys. Rio Ferdinand though, like, I know it's not all about the pace, but when you have the pace and the intelligence that this guy is going to be bringing to your team, the interceptions, 91 interceptions is actually very high, and the marking, the strength, he is a mountain. Really good card. What is the composure doing though? Because we believe it to be affecting like strikers. So say you're running through on goal and you've got like a couple of defenders around you, you're going to be able to keep composed and take the strike. So what is it really allowing a defender to do? Is it like the same but like switched? So if you have a lot of attackers coming at you, you can keep composed and make the right challenge? I have no idea. Like, I'm not even going to sit here and pretend that I know. So if you want to shed some light on that, that'd be fantastic. But 93 composure is actually very high. So whatever it does is obviously working. Hold on, what's 90 composure for Rijkaard? That's interesting because, honestly, Rijkaard is insane. Let me check. Hold on a minute. I know I wasn't supposed to be doing this, but let me quickly check Jerome Boateng's, because maybe that's what's making 86. Maybe it actually is affecting centre-backs, you know. And David Alaba, because I really like him. 79. I don't know. But that's interesting, man. And I've got literally nothing bad to say about Boateng. He's unbelievable on this game. And the pace, yeah, you can tell the difference between him and Rio Ferdinand. I would say if you're wanting to save yourself some coins, use Boateng. But if you're really looking to play those serious foot champ games, Rio Ferdinand's going to hold it down for you. So I love that. And then I was thinking, what sub do I want to bring on? So when Laurent Blanc runs out of steam, who would you have as an impact sub? Elik Steiner, would you bring him on in that CDM position? He's 6 foot. Yeah, 6 foot, high work rates. He's got some nice interceptions, agility, reactions, and all that. Or would you bring on Kolasinac? Now, for me, I dropped Kolasinac because I thought to myself, he's 6 foot. He has medium to high work rate, so he's not going to push on. And 93 strength. And I think he's one of the strongest players on the game. So who would you use? He doesn't have as good agility as Elik Steiner, but let me know in the comment section. That'd be interesting. But as you do know, we packed Lozano with our team. It would have been nice to get Mertens, and I've seen a lot of people tweet me your red Mertens, and I'm just gonna be honest, I'm jealous. I actually am jealous, because I was so desperate for him for this team. That would have just looked amazing, but it wasn't to be. Maybe next time if he can get himself an inform. By the way guys, that is my new kit. I really like it. It's got like a red tint at the top, yellow at the bottom, and it's just a really nice black kit. Anyway, let's focus on what we're coming up against. Walker FC. So our team is a lot better than his. He's using a difficult formation though, that 4-3-1-2. And when I was completing the Rio SBC, I decided to wait for a few players to go and purchase. And I jumped and had a couple of games in divisions, and I was able to win the Division 1 title. So that was an extra 15,000 coins. To unlock Rio. So we clutched up. I'm really happy with what we were able to do. And now we've got just an absolute beast. Oh, see, I wanted to inform Valencia, but I don't know how much he cost. Someone said he was 400,000 coins. On what console? PlayStation? No way. I'm not spending 400k. Oh, that went straight through him. But I was about to say, I'm not spending 400,000 coins on inform Valencia. Hell no. And purchase more icons, man, because that's what it's about. I wanted to get... See, I try to be clever. That's going to still be a goal. I try to be clever and make the extra pass so I could pass it in the back of the net. That's what I'm trying to really bring to my game. Because sometimes I just look for the quick shot. That could be a GG in Division 1. It's a GG. So this is an interesting team. 3-5-2. Inform De Gea. I don't know how good like he is compared to the non-inform. I don't think it's worth it personally. You don't want to be wasting time when Patrick Vieira is about. I saw him. Del Piero. Oh, that's going to be Lozano all day, every day. Very lucky, fortunate with that one. I was about to pop it with Del Piero. That would have either been the goal, whole possession. Look at the runs as well. It is really spreading the play. Oh my, big boy Patrick has got his debut goal, because he's played too many games. He's got his first goal for the club. He's broken the duck. Is that what you say? I think he's broken the goose. No, I don't know what it is. Well, that's a rage quit anyway. Game three, and I want to see three rage quits. Have we scored two goals in every game? Yeah, two goals in this one, a rage quit. That'd be great. He's going to go all the way. That's a nice pass inside. That's a good turn, actually. No! Ah, oh, that is so cheesy. No, don't you dare. Don't do that. Come on. That is a cheesy goal, man. I don't know how it found its way back to Royce, but it's early goal. We can bounce back. The build-up to his goal was poor defending from me, though, with Valencia. In those situations as well, I need to start getting a lot better. Well done. Good stuff. Alessandrini. go on, Del Piero. As soon as Del Piero starts running, you know, he actually picks up so much speed. Fantastic finish. That's the thing, like, when you start going against someone who's standing still, and I believe that's one of the reasons why kickoff glitch is so, well, not even a glitch, it's just why it's so overpowered, that mechanic, because it's so difficult to then, like, really recover with your defenders. He was all over the place there. Yeah, he's rushing a little bit. I couldn't, what the hell? Oh, my controller's gone off. I was about to say, what the hell? Oh my God, no. Towards the end of that first half, my controller lost its charge. I was like, Vieira, what are you doing? Pass the ball. And I don't really like playing when it's on charge. So this is going to be the last game, but we are dominating. We need that goal. Find that pass. Oh, Alessandrini. Oh, that is sweet. That was really nice play. And Del Piero, wow. That was a sitter, really, for his standard. See, Alaba, it says that he only has 69 strength, but he always is able to hold off players in that position. I do really like him. Hold on. This looks promising. Laurent Blanc. To Stegen. I need to get closer to the goal. Can we play it back? That's it. We've got good pressure now. Nice RBA pass. Speed that attack up. Del Piero. That's got to be a goal. Well, we have won the game. Well, I wouldn't say we've won the game. When the gameplay is smooth, which it has been for, I think, 2 days, 3 days in a row, maybe. 3 days at a push. Oh, God. Oh, God. That was totally my fault. But it has been really good for, like, 2 days. It's so enjoyable to play. Like, FIFA 18 is a good game when it's good. Can we bounce straight back? That's a penalty. We have done. I wouldn't even say that's cheesy. He's just run straight into the back. I usually go to the left, but today I'm going to change it up a little bit. Go to the right. I think a few people have been saving it. Even Kazooie, he saved my pen. 3 wins today, and you know how it's playing. You know what players we're going to be using for this weekend. It's whether or not we can step up in the weekend league and overcome the delay. Because recently, the game has been fantastic in divisions. Whether or not it's going to play like that in the weekend league, we've got to find out. So I really do believe that the missing piece of the puzzle was the big man, Patrick Vieira. What he's doing for the team right now, fantastic. 15 games, 1 goal, 2 assists. And in those 15 games, I can already tell you that I love the guy. Medium work rates, I don't feel that that's really that bad. Compared to his 88, which is going to offer you medium to high, I haven't noticed him not to have tracked back or not to be in a position where I can then take control of him and then mark the passing lane or go in for the challenge. So I don't think that there is an issue with his work rates at all with the way I'm playing. It could be different if you're wanting maybe to use him in a 4-3-1-2 or something like that where you need your midfielders to track back. But as I've got so much support around him, he is just holding it down in the middle, and I quite like that he's like around the halfway line playing those passes using his vision. This team is absolutely fantastic. Outstanding. Really is. And I'm able to enjoy the game because of the players that I've got right now. And it's only going to get better. We're going to be bringing in the prime Ronaldinho. That's what we need to do right now. I'm going to have to focus on real investments, making coins through trading, and start unlocking all of the prime SBCs. Just get a collection together, and then we can go and purchase the Team of the Years. Ah, it's going to be fantastic. The series is looking good. So if you have enjoyed today's episode, leave a like. Let me know in the comment section if you're investing in Player of the Month Salah, or maybe you're looking to invest in the Team of the Group Stage SBC that could potentially be released. There's no guarantee, but I think they will do it. So thanks for watching. Leave a like, and I will see you on the next one. Team out.